Suratul Waqia. Suratul Waqia, period of revelation, this surah was revealed before the affirmation of the faith by Sayyidina Umar radiallahu anhu, and it has been established historically that Umar radiallahu anhu embraced Islam after the first migration of Habsha in the fifth year of the prophethood. So here we see this surah is a Makki surah, and it has 96 verses. And what is discussed in this, the major issues is scene of the doomsday, when some will be abased and some exalted. The earth will be shaken up. The mountains will be crumbled to scattered dust. Mankind will be divided into three groups. These three groups are so important. The foremost in rank and the position, the common righteous people and the disbelievers. Admonition to the disbelievers with the example of creation. The testimony of Allah about Quran. So here very beautifully mentioned in this surah. Let's begin. A'udhu billahi minash shaitan rajim. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Iza waqat al-waqiyah. ليس للواقية كاذبة خافضة رافية إذا رجت الأرض رجا وبست الجبال بسا فكانت هباء منبثة وكنتم أزواجا ثلاثة. When the occurrence occur, there is an occurrence, no denial. It will bring down some and raise up others. When the earth is shaken with convulsion and the mountains are broken down and crumbling into pieces and become dust dispersing. So this is going to happen, you know, Waqia incident occurs. What is this incident? The day of judgment. If this is the state of mountains and the earth, earth is shaken and the mountains is crumbled, what do you think of yourself, oh man? Vakuntum azvajan salasatan, and you become of three kinds. Salasa, people, humanity will be divided into three groups. All people. Fa ashabul maymanati ma ashabul maymana. Then the companion of the right. What are the companion of the right? Fa ashabul mashama. And the companion of the left. What are the companion of the left? وَالسَّابِقُونَ السَّابِقُونَ. And the third group, the forerunners. The forerunners. This is the third group. Those who are ahead will be leading on the day of judgment. أُولَٰئِكَ مُقَرَّبُونَ. Those are the one brought near to Allah. So one group is of those who will be on the right. Another group is of those who will be on the left. And the one group, the third group, will be of those who will be in the front. They are leading. Ulaika muqarrabun. Who are these people? Those who were ahead in iman, in doing good in this world, and on the day of judgment, they will be brought near to Allah. In the gardens of pleasure, a large company of the former people and a few of the later people, but still there will be some. May Allah make us among those. In every era of the Prophet, there will be a sabihun, those who will be ahead of others in good work, in seeking good opportunities, awaiting those moments where they can be good. And there are certain deeds and make a person among the sabihun. Once a companion, he said to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, those who have property and wealth have surpassed in the reward because they have money. They do the same deed that we do. But in addition to what we do, they give in charity. Means they spend in the way of Allah. But we don't do that because we don't have money. That's what they said. So Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, shall I not tell you something which if you do, you will catch up those who have surpassed you and you will excel over those who came after you. Should I tell you about something which if you do, you will catch up those who are ahead of you. You will join their ranks. You will be the same rank as them and those behind you will never be able to catch up with you. He sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, you should say Alhamdulillah after every prayer. سبحان اللہ آفٹر ایوری پریئر، اللہ اکبر آفٹر ایوری پریئر 33 ٹائمس ایچ، اینڈ اللہ اکبر 34 ٹائمس ایچ. اف یو سے دس دین واٹ ول ہیپن؟ یو ول بی آف سابقون. بٹ دس از فار ہو؟ دا ون ہو ریگولرلی ابزرو دس. دین وائی شوڈ وی ٹیک صلاح ایز اے برڈن؟ نیور تھنک صلاح ایز اے برڈن. Why is it that we rush when it comes to Salah and we don't even pray in Sunnah? Sabiqun perform Nawafil also. They are not in rush. And many times some women, they say, maybe in ignorance, they are saying, now I'm exempted for 8 days. I don't have to pray. I'm free bird now. There's nothing to enjoy that 8 days. You can listen to Quran. You can read the Hadith. There's so many things you can do. You can memorize word to word meaning. So many other things you can do if you're not praying. Ala sururim mawduna, on thorn woven with ornament. Muttaki'een alayha mutaqabilin, reclining on them, facing each other. We want to face each other, right? When we sit, we want some most comfortable position, completely relaxed, no tension, and we want to face each other. There will be circulate among them young boys made eternal, meaning these boys will be serving them with vessel pitchers and cup of wine from a flowing spring. No headache will they have therefrom, nor will they intoxicate it. And fruits of what they select. They select because you see, sometimes you are served food and you can't exactly select it yourself. So whatever is put on your plate, you have to have it. But fruits that they will select, you have the choice. You want to choose whatever the, you know, some people like something, some people don't like the same thing. So you have the opportunity to select yourself. And the meat of fowl, meaning of birds, from whatever they desire. In their choice, when they wish they can have, whatever they wish they can have. There's a hadith, Prophet ﷺ said that certainly in Jannah there are birds that are like the size of camel necks. Right, camel necks. Imagine a camel neck. It is so huge birds. And they feed from the trees of Jannah. Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu said, Ya Rasulullah ﷺ, then those birds will be very strong and beautiful and they will be really good. Prophet ﷺ said, those who eat them will be better than them. Don't just admire the birds. Those who will eat them will be better than those birds. Subhanallah. Wahurun ayn, and for them are fair women with large, beautiful eyes. The likeness of pearls will be protected. Subhanallah, likeness of the pearls will be protected as reward for what they used to do. And you see over here what is mentioned about the birds, that they will select. Lahmi tayrin mimma yashtahun. They will select it. In Hadith also we learn that a person will see a bird, all right, and he will wish, I wish I would eat it. He will just wish it. And the end, he will see everything prepared in front of him. You know, sometimes we want to prepare something and in our imagination, we already prepared that dish. It's not so. It's really going to happen. What happened in this world, that you are just picturing that hamburger, all right, okay, that sandwich or whatever your favorite food is. And, you know, sometimes you see the picture and you start imagining that. The food you want to have it and you start thinking about it, oh, that's so delicious and so on and so forth. It's not so. You're going to have it. Jazam bima kanu yamalun, as the reward for what they used to do. What is the end result? See this jazaun. This is the jaza. Kanu yamalun. They did the amal. They work for it, isn't it? They will not hear therein ill speech or commission of sin. Ayah number 25 is important. Just underline it. They will not hear there any ill speech. In this world, no matter how delicious food is, when ill speech is there, you're not going to enjoy the food. Believe me, you can't even have one morsel. You can't even swallow it sometimes. If sometimes people are really bad to you, They misbehave you, you can't take a single morsel. Because ill speech affect you so much, but there will be no ill speech. Only saying peace, 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 salam, peaceful words. The companion of the right, now the Ashabul Yameen, what are the companions of the right? So this shows that the Sabihun, their level is higher. That it is the Ashabul Yameen, always say they will be among, and in Ayah number 28, they will be among lot trees with thorn removed, meaning no thorny plants, no thorny bushes, no thorny trees. Watalhim mandood, and also banana trees layered with fruit. Have you ever seen banana on tree? How is it? Layered, literally. And the banana tree, how is it? It's got big leaves. It's beautiful. Look at it. It's so delicate. It doesn't seem very overpowering. Wazillim mamdood, and the shade that is extended. Shade that is extended in Jannah, in paradise. The Prophet ﷺ said, there is a tree under whose shade a rider could travel for 100 years and never leave it. He could ride for 100 years and that shade would never end. Wazillim mamdood, extended. Vama'im maskub, and water poured out, and the fruits abundant and varied, neither limited to season nor forbidden. And limited we can also understand stood as maqtu'ah, that the supply would end. No, supplies will end, nor will it be forbidden, because Adam al-Islam, when he went to Jannah, there was a forbidden fruit over there. But now when people will go to Jannah, there will be no forbidden fruit. You understand? Everything is allowed. Wa furushim marfu'ah, and upon beds raised high. You know, we want comfortable bed, we go different places and we check it, we sit on it and we check. This is furushin marfua, raised bed, high bed. Indeed, we have produced the woman of paradise in a new creation, means new body. So no woman needs to have body image issues. You know, new body, like, you know, fresh. And made them virgins, pure, devoted to their husband of equal age. Ayah number 37, you know, you don't have age issue. Oh, he's younger, he's elder, so on. No, they are equal age. For the companions of the right, who are a companions of the former people and a companion of the later people and the companion of the left. What are the companion of the left? There will be in scorching fire and a scalding water and a shade of black smoke, neither cool nor beneficial. Indeed, they were before that indulging in influence. This is so frightening. You know, innahum kanu qabla zalika mutrafin. The people of the left in this world, they used to live in luxury in this world. And they used to persist in great violation. Since they persist in them. And they used to say, when we die and become dust and bones, are we indeed to be resurrected? They are asking this. And our forefathers as well. Say, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, indeed the former and the later people are to be gathered together for the appointment of a known day. Then indeed you, O those astray who are deniers, will be eating from trees of zakkum and filling with it your bellies and drinking on top of it from scalding water, and will drink as the drinking of thirsty camels. That is their accommodation on the day of recompense. نَحْنُ خَلَقْنَاكُمْ فَلَوْلَا تُصَدِّقُونَ. We have created you, so why do you not believe? أَفَرَأَيْتُمْ مَا تُمْنُونَ. Have you seen that which you emit? Meaning nutfa, that comes out of you. You are made of that, you know, watery thing. Is it you who created or we created? You know, we all have been created by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have decreed death among you and we are not above to be outdone. Meaning just Allah created you. He will also cause you to die and you cannot escape death. We are not to be outdone. In that we will change your likeness and produce you in that form which you do not know. And you have already known the first creation. So will you not remember? Have you seen that seed which you sow? Is it you who make it grow, or are we the grower? Allah is asking. And at the sign, dry seed, from it fresh, colorful, flavorful, fragrant plants come forth. Who causes it? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If we will, we could make it dry debris and you would remain in the wonder. Saying indeed, we are now in debt, meaning your gardens, your farms, you put the seed. What guarantee do you have that it will actually grow into something? If Allah wants, He could cause the entire plantation to be ruined. And when that would be ruined, what could you do? You would just remain in wonder. Saying indeed, we are now in debt. Because for a farmer, he has invested everything in this farm. And if he gets nothing out of that, he will certainly be in debt. Rather, we have been deprived. Meaning, what can you do if Allah inflicts you with harm? أَفَرَأَيْتُمُ الْمَاءَ الَّذِي تَشْرَبُونَ. And have you seen the water what you drink? Is it who brought it down from the clouds, or is it we who brings it down? Allah is asking. Another sign is mentioned. Who sends the water? Is it Allah or you? You know, if water evaporates, nothing we can do about it. If we will, we could make it bitter. So why are you not grateful? Because think about it. Majority of the water on the plant is what? Planet is what? Salty. Sea water. Water in the sea, in the oceans, it is salty. You know, when you go to beach, if you taste it, you can't, you know. If it touch your face and your body parts, how you feel like, you know, uneasy. You want to have shower. You can't drink it. Imagine of water when it is evaporated. The salts also evaporated with water. Would rain water be drinkable? What happens then? There is acid rain. Because of air pollution, the water that falls causes more corruption. It causes devastation. Things are ruined. If Allah wanted, He could have made this rain water bitter. But why are you not grateful? And have you seen the fire that you ignite? You know how we fire it? Especially when you go to forest area where you don't have anything. When you strike two stones, how it ignites the fire. Is it you who produce its trees, or we producer? We have made it a reminder and provision for the travelers. Fasabbih ismi rabbikal azim. So exalt the name of your Lord, the most great. Again, we are commanded to glorify Allah. How? With the name of Allah, azim. Fasabbih ismi rabbikal azim. This is indeed a great name of Allah, azim. So we should make dua with it and glorify Allah with it morning and evening. Subhanallah wa bihamdihi, subhanallahil azim. Fala uqsimu biwaqi' nujum. Then I swear by setting of the stars. When you see, you know, before Fajr, how the setting of the star. And indeed, it's an oath. If you could know the most great, indeed, it is more. It is a noble Quran in a register, well protected. None touch it except the purified, meaning the angels, meaning the Lohe Mahfuz, the original record of the Quran. No person can reach there. Can any human being reach there? No one can. Allah is telling us that it's beyond your reach. La yamussuhu illa mutahharun. Only the angels, the purified ones, they can reach it. Tanzeelum min rabbil alameen. It is the revelation from the Lord of the world. Afa bihazal haditha antam mudhinoon. Then it is to this statement that you are indifferent. Means the Quran, you were indifferent to it. That you don't take it time for it. You take it lightly. You don't reflect on it. You don't read it. You don't understand it. You don't implement it. No, that's what it means. Number 82. And make your provision that you deny the provider. Means Allah, He is the one who has provided you everything. How do you thank Him for His provision that you deny Him? Is this what you have to offer in return? For every blessing that He gives you, you deny Him, you reject Him. He is the provider. He gives you. He takes care of all your needs. He has provided you with everything that you need. And yet His words, you don't take His message, His teaching, you don't accept. If you think about it, any breath of air, even that we take in and we inhale, we exhale. This is also whose blessing? Allah's blessing. Constantly we are receiving this Quran also Allah has sent. How much is it we receive of the Quran? Because if you think about it, Allah gives worldly blessing to everybody, those whom He likes and also whom He does not like. But the Quran, He only gives to those who likes, those who have Iman. He only gives to those whom He likes. مَنْ يُرِيدَ اللَّهَ بِهِ خَيْرٍ يُفَقِّهُ فِي الدِّينِ. So how much we are taking it? Then why when the soul at the death reaches the throat and you are at what time looking on and our angels are nearer to him than you, but you do not see, then why do you not, if you are not be recompensed, bring it back if you should be truthful? Meaning if you think there is no God, if you think there is no afterlife, if you think no one is going to question you about what you are doing, if you think there is no one greater than you above you, then try to escape death. Can you? It's impossible for you to escape death. And once a soul leaves, can you bring that soul back? No way. How much they improve in technology, they can't bring death back to alive. So if you are truthful in this claim of yours that you have all powers, it's your life. If you are truthful in this claim that's your life, then show it's proof that's your life. Can you avoid death? This is the reality. Everybody has to taste the death. Bring it back if you should be truthful. And if the deceased was of those brought near to Allah, means dying person, if he are of the Muqarrabin. And those who are Muqarrabin, who are those will be brought near to Allah, the Sabiqun. And then for him, rest and bounty and a garden of pleasure. Meaning when the soul of righteous is taken, it is taken up to the sky. Gates are open and then soul is welcome. How is that person welcome? The angels say to him, Marhaban bi nafsi tayyiba. Kanat bi jasadin tayyiba. Udkhulil hamida. Wa abshir bi ruhi wa raihani wa rabbi ghairi ghadban. Welcome, O pure soul. That was a pure body. Binafsin tayyiba kanat fi jasadin tayyiba. Enter. They are welcome. Enter as you are praiseworthy. Udkhulil hamid and rejoice with ruh and rehan. Bounty, favors from Allah and rehan. And here ruh and rehan is also fragrance, rewards. And you see, you smell something before you see it. So at the time of death, the angels bring fragrance for a person. They perfume the soul. The shroud that they bring for the soul is also perfume. And come to a Rabb, that is ghaira ghadban, a Lord that is not angry with you. This is for who? Sabiqun. And if he was of the companion of the right. Salamun laka min ashabil yameen. Then angels will say peace for you from the companions of the right. Then he welcome, but there isn't the red carpet service for the one who is at Sabiqun. But if he was of the deniers who were asked in the third category, then for him is the accommodation of scalding water, burning fire. Inna haza lahuwa al-haqqul yaqeen. Indeed, this is the true certainty. There is no doubt. Fasabbi bi ismi rabbikal azim. So exalt the name of your Lord, the most great. Because death is certain. You can't escape death. Fasabbi bi ismi rabbikal azim. Allah tell us the glory for your Lord. Don't delay. Don't delay tasbih till, you know, just doing tasbih at particular time, like, you know, Ramadan time, then you are leaving. No. Do tasbih. So remember, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, whoever says Subhanallah al-Azim wa bihamdihi, then a date palm tree is planted for him in Jannah. Subhanallah al-Azim wa bihamdihi. It is planted for him. So it is up to us how many trees we want to plant in a day. You see, sometimes you are waiting and you are getting so angry. My time is getting wasted. My children, my family, my husband. Instead, say Subhanallah wa bihamdihi. You want to plant a tree. Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam also said, if anyone says 100 times in the morning, Subhanallahil Azim wa bihamdi, and says likewise in the evening, Subhanallahil Azim wa bihamdi, 100 times, then no one from the creation will bring anything like the one which he will bring. Then he is of the Sabiqun. He is the one, those who are at the top. No one will bring that he has brought. Subhanallahil Azim wa bihamdi. And remember the name of Allah. Azim is such that when a person makes dua with the name of Allah Azim, then Allah certainly responds and Allah likes tasbih. Allah likes glorification. So here, next is the Suratul Hadid. This surah, it starts with Sabbaha. So let's begin this surah. Before that, let's see the revelation period. This surah that was revealed at Medina during the interval between the Battle of Uhud and truce of Hudaybiyah between 4th and 5th year after Hijrah. It was revealed at that time when the tiny Islamic state of Medina was hemmed in by disbelievers and the handful of ill-equipped Muslims were trenched against the combined powers of entire Arabia. In such circumstances, not only stood in need of sacrifice of life from its followers, but it is also needed monetary help and assistance. In this surah, a forceful appeal has been made for the same. And major issues is Allah created heaven and earth in 6 days. And on the day of judgment, the true believers will have their lights shining before them, while the hypocrites will have a fate similar to the disbelievers. Those who spend in charity will be repaid manyfold. The life of this world is but a play, amusement and illusion. Do not grieve for the things that you miss, nor overjoy what you gain. Prophet Nuh al-Islam, Ibrahim al-Islam and Isa al-Islam were sent for the guidance in the right way. And as you know, this starts with Sabbaha and describing, praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It has 29 verses and Suratul Hadid is Madani Surah. Let's begin. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Sabbaha lillahi ma fis samawati wal ard wa huwal azizul hakim. Whatever is in the heaven and earth exalts Allah. Every creature is glorifying Allah. That you, O Allah, are free from every fault and every imperfection. You are perfect one, free of any association, any partnership or any resemblance to your creation. Wa huwal azizul hakim. And he is the exalted and might and wise. Tasbih is the prayer of the entire creation. Nuh al-Islam, he said to his son before his death that tasbih is the prayer of every creation. Because of this prayer, they are given provision. They are provided. So entire creation is doing tasbih. What do we have to do? Do tasbih. He is the dominion of the heaven and the earth. He gives life and causes death. And he is over all things competent. Wa huwa al-awwal wa-akhir wa-zahir wa-batin wa-huwa bi-kulli shayin alim. He is the first and the last, the ascendant and the intimate. And he is of all things knowing. It is he who created heaven and earth in 6 days and then established himself above the throne. يَعْلَمُ مَا يَلِجُ فِي الْأَرْضِ وَمَا يَخْرُجُ مِنْهَا. He knows what penetrates into the earth, what emerges from it. وَمَا يَنْزِلُ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ وَمَا يَعْرُجُ فِيهَا. And what descends from the heaven and what ascends therein. فَهُوَ مَعَكُمْ أَيْنَ مَا كُنْتُمْ. And he is with you wherever you are. وَاللَّهُ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ بَصِيرٌ. And Allah of what you do is seeing. Here's some more names of Allah, some more attributes of Allah mentioned. That firstly, he is Awwal and Akhir, the first and the last, meaning none was before him, none shall be after him. And he is Zahir, meaning the dominant, Ghalib. And he is Batin, meaning Qareeb, the one who is near and knowing of everything. Wahuwa bikulli shayin alim. He knows about everything. Suhail radiallahu anhu reported that Abu Salih used to command us in these words. These are the people of early generation. This hadith in Sahih Muslim, he said, Abu Salih radiallahu anhu used to command us that when any one of you intends to go to sleep, he should lie on the bed on his right side and this ألا هم رب السماوات ورب الأرض ورب العرش العظيم، ربنا ورب كل شيء، فالق الحب والنوى ومنزل التوراة والإنجيل والفرقان، أعوذ بك من شر كل شيء أنت آخذ وأنت آخذ ذنبي سيئاتي. اللهم أنت أول فليس قبلك شيء، وأنت خير فليس بعدك شيء، وأنت ظاهر فليس فوقك شيء، وأنت باطن فليس دونك شيء. أخفض عنا ديننا وأغنينا من الفقر. So you see the last part that, oh Allah, remove the burdens of death from us and relieve us from what? Meaning you take care of all debts, all our loans, free us from poverty. And Abu Saleh said that he used to narrate this from Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu, who narrate this from Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is also one of the duas we can say before we go to sleep. Remember the name of Allah. When you remember these names of Allah, really all your problems will go away. Because generally what happens when you lie down, when your body relax, your mind does not relax, does it? You start worrying about your problems. And for many people, what are their problems? Their debts, their loans, financial burdens, fees, or for instance, the loan or the car of the rent, and so many other things, you know. Just make dua and do this zikr. And ayah number 4, and also we see in the next ayah that Allah, where is he? On his throne, yet he is near because he is Allah. It's amazing. So mastawa alal arsh, he is on the throne, and the wahwa ma'akum aina ma kuntum, because he is Allah. We are limited in our knowledge, in our ability, but Allah is on throne, yet his knowledge encompassing everything. Nawab said, we were told that Allah says to his angels, call my servants for me, and they say, how our Lord, when there are 7 skies separating them and there is arsh above them, how is your servant meant to reach you? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, when they say la ilaha illallah, they shall be responded. Iza qalu la ilaha illallah istajabu, they will be responded. So la ilaha illallah, taking the names of Allah, this is our connection with Allah. Really, it covers up all the distance that may be between you and Allah. And Allah is qareeb, mujib. How is it that we find ourselves close to Allah? By learning about him, by knowing his name, Asmaul Husna. Lahu mulku samawati walad, he is the dominion of the heaven and earth, and to Allah and return all matters. He causes the night to enter the day and causes the day to enter the night. He is knowing of that within the chest. Believe in Allah and his messenger and spend out of that in which he has made you successor. Meaning, you just have this wealth temporarily, right? You got it from somebody and very soon it will pass down to somebody else when you die. For those who have believed among you and spent it, there will be a great reward. Ajrun Kabir. A great reward is for who? For those who believe and spend in the way of Allah. So give happily, begin with yourself, and then others also spend on yourself, and that which will benefit your deen, that will be benefit for your akhirah, and spend on others also. And why do you not believe in Allah? Well, the messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam invites you to believe in your Lord, and he has taken your covenant if you should truly be believers. It is who sends down upon his servant Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam verses of clear evidence that he may bring out from darknesses into the light. And indeed, Allah is to you kind and merciful. Ayah number 10. Why do you not spend in the cause of Allah? While to Allah belongs the heritage of heaven and earth. Here we see Allah is rich. If you give him, he will give you more. This is just like if there is an investor, billionaire, even more than that. Do you have any hesitation spending your money, investing your money? No, right? For example, if you spend some money and you are sure that you'll get back, this is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala majesty. Spend in the way of Allah. Allah will give you, and many folds we have learned in Surah Al-Baqarah. Not equal among you are those who spend before the conquest of Makkah and fought, and those who did so after it. Those are greater in degree than they who spend afterwards. towards the fort, but to Allah has promised the best reward, and Allah with what you do acquainted. What we see over here is the sacrificing time of the need. That is real sacrifice, for that is the reward that is unmatched. That is why Prophet ﷺ said, if any one of you were to spend gold equal to the Mount of Uhud, you could not reach the level of Sahaba companion. Why? Because what they did, we can never do that, because they work with Prophet ﷺ. They sacrifice the time of great hardship. So they got the reward that were unmatched. So likewise, those who respond early, those who are sabiqun, those who are ahead, their reward is unmatched. So here we see, who is it that would loan Allah a good loan? He will multiply it for him and he will have a noble reward. What is that? Qara than hasana. So to spend in the way of Allah, for the sake of attaining Allah's pleasure, for the sake of propagating the religion of Allah, whatever it is needed, this could be in spending on oneself. Like, for example, a person spend money in order to get a particular class, for example, to buy certain books or enroll in a course. So any spending, even if that in a few dollars, remember that is going in the way of Allah. Allah take it as a loan, because he will pay you back. He will return you. He will not leave you empty handed. He will not leave you poor. He will return. And that this includes all the spending. You know, many people, they say, we spend so much money in our Islamic classes, Islamic courses, learning tajweed. Yeah, Allah will give you back in many folds. Whatever you are putting for the sake of Allah, when you are learning or your children learning, your family learning, or otherwise you are just donating money for the sake of Allah to propagate the deen of Allah, Allah will give you many more folds. And many times we criticize many Islamic, universities or Islamic educational centers. Oh, they are charging so much money. That is their prerequisite, because how they will propagate deen without taking money? They have to pay, and they charge only minimum amount. So here in ayah number 12, on the day you see believing men and believing women, their light receding before them on their right, it will be said, your good tidings today are of gardens beneath which rivers flow, wherein you will be abide eternally. This is what is the great attainment. On the same day, the hypocrites men and hypocrites women will say to those who believe, wait for us that we may acquire some of our light. So you see, the hypocrites will say, let us borrow some of our light. But it will not work, because each person shall have his own light, and the light on that day will be determined by the person's iman in this world, his action, his sadaqa. It will be said, go back behind you and seek light. Meaning, here you can find any light. If you want light, you have to go back to the world. But is there any going back to the world? No way. We learned that before Sirat, before the bridge, people will fall in darkness. They will come on the bridge to cross it. And people will give in their light. How much light? Each person will be given a light according to his deed. However, this deed shall be, that is how his light will be. And there's a hadith, Prophet ﷺ said, the people will be given their light in proportion to their deeds. Among them is he who will receive his light like a date palm tree. Can you imagine? So tall, huge. Among them is he who will receive that until the last day is given light on the large toe of his feet. Some people, their light will be like a huge tall column, like a huge pillar. And some, their light will be less than, and some, their light will be just where on the toes that it is. And this will also flick, go on and off, become bright and also become dim. And then people will have to cross the bridge. And as people will cross the bridge, some people, they will cross easily, quickly, as a flash of light, the blink of an eye, like fast wind, like birds flying, like animals running. Meaning, these are just example how speed will be on the day of judgment. And the Prophet ﷺ described the Sirat. He said, this will pass on the Sirat, which is sharper than the sword, meaning it's slippery, unstable, and it is also thinner, finer than a hair. It will be said to them, move in proportion to your light. So some will pass over it like the diving of the stars. You see, shooting stars, just like some people will move. Some will pass like the wind. Some will pass like a blinking of an eye. Some among them will pass like a fast racing horses, and some will pass like a person walking very quickly. They pass over in accordance to their deeds until one pass over it, whose light is on the last toe of his feet. So what will happen? He will slip because it will be dark and his speed will be so less, he will slip. So his hand will fall and another hand will raise up. A leg will fall, another leg will raise up, meaning he will be crawling, and his sides will be afflicted by fire. So because on the sides of Sirat there are hooks, the Sirat, remember, this bridge is on the hellfire. It is over hellfire, blazing hellfire, and he will be afflicted by the fire. Then some will be saved and some will fall, and those who will be saved, they will say, Alhamdulillah, all praise for Allah who saved us from, meaning hellfire, after we have seen you. So each person will be given his light according to his or her deed. Some people will be given light where? On their toe. Just imagine how little that light is. And it will be flickering on and off, dim and bright, because this is how their iman was. This is how their deeds were. Earlier, we learned that deeds which Allah likes are those who are, which are, yes, consistent, regular. If a person at point, yes, there is salah, and another point, no salah. One day a lot of Quran, another day nothing. Consistency matters. That is so important. Remember, this is real. This is what every one of us to go through. What kind of light do we want on day of judgment? Whatever light we want, that is what we have to do right now. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He was shown as the light of Quran, then let us be firm, consistent, and have istiqamat. Let us remain attached to some good work so that we do not take a step back, we do not fall back. This journey is inevitable. Each person has to cross the bridge. So mass and collect as much light for yourself as possible. Spread khair around you. On your right, on your left, before you, after you, whatever you accumulate good. Why? So that you have noor on the day of judgment. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, each person, believer or hypocrites, will be given his light. Each person. Because remember, these believers have already been taken into the fire. These are who? Those who say they are believers, whether their iman is real or not, sincere or not, each person will be granted this light. So we should strive with our action, because noor is iman, and amal and iman, by the way, it's not just the state of the heart, it also includes action. Just saying la ilaha illallah and not praying, not doing any action, no, action of a person. And also we should ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala noorul Huda, especially the dua of Noor. At what time? When is it that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught us to do dua Noor? If you don't know it, you should know it at Fajr time, especially after Sunnah, before Fajr. Which dua it is? I will repeat it. Allahumma ja'alni fi qalbi noora wa fi basari noora wa fi sam'i noora wa an yamini noora wa an yasari noora wa fawqi noora wa tahti noora wa imami noora wa qalbi noora wa ja'alni noora wa fi lisani noora wa asbi noora wa lahmi noora wa dam نورا وشائر نورا وبشر نورا وجعل لي في نفسي نورا وعزم لي نورا اللهم آتيني نورا يوم يقول منافقنا ومنافقات للذين آمنوا انظرونا نقتبس من نوركم. On the same day, hypocrite men and hypocrite women will say to those who believe, wait for us that we may acquire some of our light. It will be said, go back, irji, behind you and seek light. فَدُرِبَ بَيْنَهُمْ بِسُرٍ لَهُ بَابٌ بَاطِنُهُ فِيهِ رَحْمَةٌ وَزَاهِرُهُ مِنْ قَبْلِهِ الْعَذَابِ. And a wall will be placed between them with a door, A wall will be placed so that they cannot share anyone's light and its interior containing mercy, but on the outside its torment, meaning those who manage to cross with their Noor, they are in mercy. Those who left in darkness are in the torment. And this Dua-e Noor is also there in the Fortress of Muslim or Vayyaka Nasta'in, and also you can find on Al Huda website. And this is recorded in Binti Huda, Asma Al Huda. It is recorded, you can listen to that also. It's there on Al Huda website, alhudapk.com. Ayah number 14, the hypocrites will call to the believers, "Where we not with you?" They will say, "Bala, bala, kinnakum fatantum anfusakum wa tarabastum wa arb. وارتبتم وقرتكم الأماني حتى جاء أمر الله وقركم بالله الغرور." Yes, but you afflicted yourself and awaited misfortune for us, and doubted and wishful thinking deluded you until there come the command of Allah and the deceiver deceive you concerning Allah. What is the fault of the hypocrites? فتنتم, you put yourself in fitna. Means you put yourself in sin, choose to disobey Allah. You made the choice and then tarabbastum, and you were waiting, never really deciding to go along with Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, never really deciding to go along with the believers. No, tarabbastum, you just waited for, just delayed tarabbastum, and you waited for bad things to happen. And the believer, that those who are striving, if you are sitting back, mocking at them, waiting to see when they will fail and when they will suffer. A believer always wants good for the believer, for his struggling believer, brother or sister. This is a nifaq, that a person just sits back and observe, look at those who are struggling in the way of Allah, waiting to see when they will suffer, when they will get harmed. No. Warabattum, you doubted, you had no conviction, this was your problem. And ultimately, gharrat kumul amani, false hopes, they decided you until death came, and shaitan kept you in delusion that nothing will happen, Allah is forgiving and merciful, you are perfectly fine, you don't need to do anything. Death came to you and your time was up. And here, so today, no ransom will be taken from you or from those who disbelieve. Your refuge is fire. It is most worthy of you, and wretched is its destination. Alam ya'ni lil-lazina amanu an taqsha qulubuhum li-zikrillah. He has the time not come for those who has believed, their heart should become humbly submissive at the remembrance of Allah and what has come down on the earth. And let them not be like those who were given the scripture before, because the people of the book, they received the scripture, they learned the knowledge, but they didn't put into action. What happened? A long period passed over, they had the Quran, they had the book, they had scripture, but they were disconnected with the scripture. And when they were disconnected with the scripture, and a long period passed over them, so their hearts hardened, and many of them are defiantly disobedient. So even when they read scripture, it doesn't affect them, it doesn't melt them, they have only increase in their sin. I'alamu, know that Allah gives life to earth after its lifelessness. We have made clear to you the signs. Perhaps you will be understanding. Inna al-musaddiqina wal-musaddiqati wa-aqradu Allah qaradan hasana yuta'afu lahum wa-lahum ajrun kareem. Indeed, the men who practice charity and the women who practice charity, and they who have loaned Allah goodly loan, it will be multiplied for them and they will have noble reward. Look at here, men and women separately mentioned. So qaradan hasana, give. Whoever wants to increase his wealth, he should give qaradan hasana. And those who have believed in Allah and his messenger, those are in the ranks of the supporter of the truth. Ulaika humus siddiqun, they are very truthful people. And the martyrs with their Lord, for them in their reward and their light, they will have light. But those who have disbelieved and denied our verses, those are the companions of the hellfire. Iyalamu, know that the life of the world is but amusement and the diversion and adornment and boasting to one another and competition in the increase of wealth and children. This is the reality of this life. Like the example of a rain whose resulting plant growth pleases the tillers, then it dries and you see it turn yellow, then it becomes scattered debris, and in the hereafter you see your punishment and forgiveness from Allah and approval. And what is the worldly life except the enjoyment of delusion? This is temporarily pleased, but then finish it, it dies, it fades you. So what you should rush to for akhirah? Sabiquna illa ila maghfiratum min rabbikum, race towards forgiveness from your Lord and the guardians whose will is like the width of heaven and the earth. Why are you running after a house that barely, 2,500 square feet or so? You're gonna have, you can't even imagine. Sabiquna ila maghfiratin min rabbikum. So sabiquna ila maghfiratin min rabbikum wa jannati arduha ka ardi samai wal ard. Run to the gardens whose wide is length like the wide of the heaven and the earth. Whenever you feel that, this worldly houses, you should think about the akhirah home. That is the main thing. Prepare for those who believe in Allah and His Messenger. Zalika fadlullahi yudhi man yasha. That is the bounty of Allah which He gives to whom He wills, and Allah is the possessor of great bounty. If you see this, this is repeated. Fafirru ilallah sabiqu sabiqun ma asaba min musibatin fil ardi wala fi anfusikum. No disaster strikes upon the earth or among yourself, except that it is in a register before we bring it to into the being. Indeed, that for Allah is easy. In order that you not despair over what has eluded to you and exult in pride over what He has given you. If you lose something, if you gain something, this was written from before. So don't feel happy about what you have received. Don't feel sad of over what you lost. It was predetermined. And Allah does not like everyone self-deluded and boastful. In ayah number 24, those who are stingy and enjoy upon people's stinginess, whoever turns away, then indeed Allah is free of need and praiseworthy. Allah is ghani. We have already sent our messengers with clear evidence and sent down with them scripture and the balance that the people may maintain their affairs in justice. We send down iron wherein great military might and benefits for the people so that Allah may make evident those who support him and his messenger unseen. So iron has been mentioned. That is the surah name Hadid. That is ayah number 25. Indeed, Allah is powerful and exalted in might. So we see that Allah revealed these things, Kitab, Mizan, and He also sent down Hadith, iron. These are meant to be used for the promotion of the deen. So now, right now, we use laptop, we use different gadgets that are made of iron, isn't it? We are using in the obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Arsalna Nuhan wa Ibrahim, and we have certainly sent Nuh and Ibrahim and placed in their descendants prophethood and scripture, and among them is he who guarded, but many of them are defiantly disobedient. In ayah number 27, then we send following their footsteps our messengers and follow them with Isa, the son of Maryam, and gave him gospel, and we place in the hearts those who follow him companions and mercy and monotheism, and which they inverted. Innovated, yeah, like the invention, Rahbaniya, monotheism, is what is that? Leave this world, meaning go to an extreme in worship. That worship, person cuts off from relatives, even does not enjoy halal thing. That's not the thing. We did not prescribe it for them, except they did so seeking the approval of Allah, but they did not observe it with due observance. So we gave the ones who believe among them their reward, but many of them are defiantly disobedient. In ayah number 28, O you who have believed, ittaqallah, fear Allah and believe in His messenger. He will then give you a double portion of His mercy in dunya and akhirah and make for you a light by which you will walk in this world and also on the day of judgment, and forgive you, and Allah is forgiving and merciful. In ayah number 29, this is so that the people of scripture may know they are not able to obtain anything from bounty of Allah, and that all bounty is in the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He gave scripture, they didn't give it in haq, then Allah gave hidayah, someone else. He gave it to whom He wills, and Allah is the possessor of great bounty. So all of our efforts and striving should be for what? Pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because if Allah is happy with us, then we are successful. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be happy with all of us. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته جزاك الله خيرا كثيرا